What is up, everybody? Today we're going to take a look at a fun little robot slash automaton I designed that continuously climbs up this ladder. And as you saw in the introduction, when it gets to the top, it automatically slides back down so that it can start climbing again. And the design of the robot is actually pretty simple. I have a standalone version here, so we can take a closer look at how it works. The motor drives this crankshaft running across the body, which drives these two lift arms for the legs. And they're just constrained loosely between the arms of these Technic connector bricks so that the feet end up traveling through a circular motion. The hands are just these one by one Technic beams which slide along the back of the ladder. And one reason it'll work so nicely is that the model is pretty back heavy, so it continuously wants to fall out from the ladder. And of course the hands stop it from doing that. As a result, the feet are always driving down and into the ladder rungs, which allow them to move the model up as they rotate. I think the most critical design element of the robot itself are the feet. It's really important that the grip of the feet on the rungs is strong enough so that they don't slip off when they're pushing the robot up, but also weak enough to actually slip off once the other foot steps on the next rung. And I went through quite a few different foot and rung designs trying to make rudimentary claws or angled toes before finally finding out, pretty much by accident, that the groove at the bottom of these tiles pretty much gives the perfect results. They just barely catch on the edge of the tiles I'm using for the ladder rungs. The other big component of the design is the return system for the robot, which allows it to slide back down. When the robot gets to the top, the hands pass through what is essentially a spring-loaded one-way valve. After that, they are pushed up into the inside of these arch pieces, which draws the hands further into the ladder, which causes the robot to lose its footing, and then it falls. As it falls, the hands are diverted into a channel further back, which draws the robot tight against the front of the ladder, ensuring the feet no longer catch on the rungs. The hands then come to rest on this lift arm, which is attached to this track in the back. There are a couple of things going on to ease the fall of the robot. One, the track drives this flywheel at the bottom, which prevents it from moving too quickly. And two, there's a counterweight on the opposite side of the track, and this also serves double duty to bring the lift arm back to the top after the robot starts climbing again. When the robot gets to the bottom, the hands pass forward into the climbing channel again, which allows the robot to lean back out from the ladder, drives the feet into the ladder rungs, and starts climbing again. I also added these spring-loaded lift arms, which just eases the transition when the robot gets to the bottom. But even with them, the robot goes through a lot of stress during the fall, which is why I have all these lift arms on its side to reinforce it. And because I'm sure some people will be curious, I'm using these circuit cubes components for the motor and battery. They result in a much smaller model than I could have made with stock Lego electronics. And I'll add some information in the description for those that are curious about them. And that is about it for this one. I had a lot of fun designing and building this model, and I hope you enjoyed the video. As always, thanks for watching, keep on building, and I'll see you in the next one.